Як приємно бачити, що так багато вірних зібрано на відправі Божественної літургії, в котрій ми поминаємо нашого покійного патріарха Йосипа, сліпого, просто 20-ту річницю того дня народження. Це була важна особа в історії нашої церкви та нашого народу. І всі нагоди вітаємо особливих шановних гостей, всесвячеслічного отця Івана Дацька, від директора храму Святого Софії в Римі, всесвячеслічного отця Андрія Онеферко з Інституту Щитицького в Оталії, та також всесвячеслічного отця Мар'яна Процек з Бафловша. І тепер запрошуємо отця Дачка виголосити проповідь сьогодні. Слава Ісусу Христу!
Слава Ісусу Христу! Ваше високопреосвященство, високопреосвященство, архієпископи і митрополити Степане, пресвятіші отці, преподобні сестри, дорогі в Христі браття і сестри, коли сьогодні перед кількома хвилинами я входив у цей чудовий катедральний собор, то звучала покаянна стихіра нашого великого композитора Артема Веделя «Покаяння відкрий мені двері». «Open the doors of repentance». These were the words which one could hear when we entered this beautiful cathedral. Ми є в часі літургійному покаянню. We are in this liturgical time of penance, reconciliation, forgiveness, mercy and kindness. І ми хочемо в особливий спосіб приготуватися до того праздника праздників Христового Воскресіння. Ми сьогодні святкуємо в особливий спосіб пам'ять сьомого Вселенського собору, в яким отці собору і Вселенської церкви проголосили святість ікони, що ми не поклоняємося ті дощі, але ми поклоняємося триєдиному Богові, Богоматері і святим. We today tend to idealize the first millennium of the history in the history of the church, because indeed the church then was one and undivided. But nevertheless, we cannot forget the fact that the first millennium was also the millennium of great heresies, of great mistakes, such as Arianism, Nestorianism, monophysitism, and iconoclasm. And the feast which we celebrate today, we commemorate the 7th Ecumenical Council of Nicaea, which proclaimed that yes,
we should venerate the holy icons, because we do not venerate that piece of wood or even that image which we see on the icon, but we pray and venerate the triune God. We venerate the holy Theotokos, the mother of God, or the saints, the fathers of the Council of Nicaea, with the blessing of Bishop of Rome, under the guidance of Patriarch Tarasius, Taras, proclaim this Sunday as Nedelya Pravoslavia, Orthodox Sunday. We Catholics tend to be afraid of that term, Orthodox, and we counterpose it to the concept or towards the understanding of Catholicism. But this is a mistake. Catholicism and Orthodoxy complement each other. The Catholic Church is as Orthodox as Orthodox should be Catholic. If we divide it, if regretfully we had to go through this period of separation, it was not because the Church was Catholic or Orthodox. It was because we children of Christ Church were sinful. So let's not be afraid of this liturgical, theological term which we use during our liturgies. Because even blessed Pope John Paul II said that when Saint Volodymyr of Kiev accepted Christianity, the Church was one and undivided, and was Orthodox in faith and Catholic in love. But today, сьогодні, ми в особливий спосіб вшановуємо пам'ять великого мужа нашої Української греко-католицької церкви, святої пам'яті Слуги Божого Патріарха Йосифа, якого 120-ліття з дня народження ми торжественно совершаємо. It is hard to believe that it is already 28 years since this great man of the Church passed away and went over to eternal life. Indeed, I remember the month of September of 1976, when this man stood at this place where I stand now and preached at the funeral of the late Metropolitan Ambrose Senecian. We today, in this time of penance and reconciliation, we want to remember in a special way not just this historical figure of Joseph Slipyj, but it is our duty to remind ourselves of his legacy, of his heritage, of his vision, of his prophecy, and what our Church should, towards what it should strive to in the nearest future. Патріарх Йосиф не був лише великою особистістю. Він не був лише ісповідником. He was also a prophet.
He closed his eyes forever on the 7th of September of 1984. And only 8 years after his death, we could already fulfill his wish to transfer his mortal rest from the crypt of Saint Sophia to the crypt of Saint George's in Lviv, Ukraine. Let us try to recall 1984. We all thought that the Soviet Union, that this atheist communist regime will perhaps not last forever, but will last for a long time. Well, I will never forget the words of Patriarch Joseph. Лихо і зло довго тривати не будуть. Wickedness and malice will not, cannot last for a long time. And despite the might, the strength, the armaments, this Soviet Union disintegrated only 8 years after his death. Did we really believe that in 8 years, rather in 6 years, Ukraine would be, in 7 years, Ukraine would be independent? Так, ми молилися за волю і свободу України, незалежність української держави. But let's be sincere, did we really believe in this? Hardly. Perhaps the righteous people did. But it happened. God is stronger than any person, any system on earth. Let us recall today's gospel. Christ calling his first apostles and disciples. And here we see Philip, who meets his friend Nathanael. And Nathanael is trying to be smart. He said, what good can come out of Nazareth? And Philip just tells him, be quiet, come and see. He sees Christ. Christ addresses him with a few words. I knew you already when you were lying under the fig tree. And Nathanael accepts Christ, and he says, Господи, ти владика, ти Господь і цар Ізраїля. You are my Lord and King of Israel. Christ indeed is strong. With the blessing of his beatitude, Patriarch Sviatoslav, and this was already prepared when his beatitude, Patriarch Emeritus Cardinal Husar, was still heading our church. I was asked by them to travel and preach the legacy of Patriarch Joseph. I had this privilege to be his secretary and chancellor in the last 8 years of his life. And I think it is our duty of gratitude. I want to say thank you to him for what he did for me personally. I am too small just to say thank you. I think we, the entire church, should say thank you, Patriarch Joseph, Дякую, патріарші Йосифе, за твоє життя, за твоє свідчення, за твоє ісповідництво, за твоє мучеництво, за твою візію, за твою спадщину і за твій заповіт. We here in the Western Hemisphere, thanks to the more or less good life we have, tend to forget the past years of persecutions, of trampling of human rights. We all, more or less, live well. And the person who has enough to eat usually does not understand the person who is hungry. God indeed has blessed our church with great people. He has shown us his strength. Він показав нам свою силу і владу. Але він нас і досвідчав. He showed to us that if we want to be good, faithful children of God, we had to suffer. We were persecuted. We bore witness of Christ. I didn't do it. Probably you did not. Oh, Patriarch Joseph, Metropolitan Andrei Sheptychki, and all those 27 martyrs and confessors who were beatified by the blessed Pope John Paul II on the 27th of June of 2001 in Lviv, and those known and unknown lay people, nuns, priests, religious, bishops, they bore this witness to Christ. Вони свідчили Христові, і завдяки їхньому свідченню ми нині, незважаючи на всі проблеми, що ще існують в нашій церкві чи в нашій державі, ми втішаємося свободою і, напевно, будемо розвиватися і рости.